tough call this morning. Is the risk golf going to continue, or are we going to consolidate? I'm on the consolidation trade today, maybe a continuation tomorrow, and a continuation Friday. Just take a look at this BTP trade. Pretty severe. Now let's take a look at the Euro Yen, which is our version of that trade. Same severity. It feels like we just printed this 124.67 yesterday. We got some more jawboning from the Italian political scene. And now we're just going to be sort of 124.50, 126.50 for today. And you'll see maybe some aggressive moves through 125.60 on the top side. And you'll see a green day today. But within the general scheme of things, we're expecting now a sideways movement with a real hard cap up here at 129, which I know is a long ways away, so it's hard to structure trades because the risk reward now is upside down. And if you look at the Euro Swiss chart, we saw capitulation yesterday with a vicious move to 113.67. Now we're back sort of at that breakdown area, 114.55. And then if you read the newspapers today, in Bloomberg, FT, Wall Street Journal, you're seeing some cracks in the trade. Basically, some asset managers are aiming to take profit in this. It's come too far. And this is just going to seep into the psyche of the marketplace overall. So we will not be selling low ones in yen crosses today. We will not be smashing euros. We'll be patient, and we'll pick our spots if we see a big move higher. What do we have today? We got German unemployment today. HICP inflation this afternoon out of Germany, which is interesting. We have ADP employment and US GDP today, 215 and 230. So this will be interesting. Beige book also this evening. And of course the Bank of Canada decision, which we'll talk more about at the New York Open. But just as a note, today we're looking for range. So we don't think, or we think there'll be a marginal low broken here in the Euro. You can pick up low ones on the Euro, and you can sell high ones also. We are not momentum trading any of this now. 114.85 looks like a very logical place for Euro to stop. Maybe take out some stops here through 115. But I think this thing is going to take a breather today. And let's follow the news flow, see what the Bank of Italy people are saying. Visco, obviously, the Bank of Italy governor said there's no justifications for market turmoil. This was the comment that moved Euro back up and Euro Swiss back up. I'm not saying this is over. I'm just saying this move is going to take a rest today. In the U.S. world, you can sell high ones now in S&Ps. Even though we did have a nice move up from 74 and we closed up at 92, this is a close below 2700. Technically speaking, it's bearish. The U.S. market has been immune to any kind of contagion with Europe getting its ass kicked, but I would argue that immunity is short-lived, and you're going to see this market sort of catch up in a way with the rich risk-off sentiment elsewhere in the world. Bitcoin, of course, is much higher, 5% yesterday. Nice bullish engulfing bar. If you were lucky enough to get some at 7,200, same strategy. We're selling sort of 8,200 and 9,200. Keep 10 or 20% of position for the long haul at a very, very good average. We didn't have a bid in. We were busy doing other things. But that is the strategy for Bitcoin. And, of course, with market turmoil, you could argue that this would be positive and create bullish flow in the crypto world. Good luck out there, people. I will see you at the New York Open.